In this video, we'll be proving what we have in the board. We have I is equal to negative of I. Say that this and this are the same. How is that possible? Now, first of all, you know what your I is. Your I is said to be the square root of negative 1. Okay, so if this is the case, that would mean that negative of I would be what? Negative square root of negative 1. Okay, now I want to bring to your notice this algebra rule. Now, if we have two numbers, okay, let's say b times square root of a in solid form. All right, having these numbers in solid form, I would say that this is the same thing as saying the square root of a times b squared. That is to say that this was outside this square root, you square it, make it become a perfect square. You can still put it inside the square root, such that if you want to evaluate this, you will take the b's out, okay? You want to square both of them. This is something as saying square root of a times square root of b squared. So square root of b squared will give us b. So b times square root of a. All right. So this is exactly what you have. So we're going to use this and this in this problem. Okay. So making use of that, I would simply say that negative I is equal to, I can split this, negative 1 times square root of negative 1. Okay, so recall that I said that b times square root of a is the same thing as saying square root of a times b squared. Alright, so in this case, our negative 1 outside here is the b. Alright, and also notice that in this our particular case, that a here and b are the same. So let's square this. Squaring b, let's square this negative 1. The square of negative 1 gives us 1. So that would mean the square root of negative 1 times the square of b here gives us b squared. So the square of negative 1 will give us 1 times 1. Okay? So evaluating this, you have what? The square root of negative 1, which is equals to I. Therefore, negative I is equal to I. Okay, I is equal to negative I. Say that this and this are the same. How is that possible? Now, first of all, you know what your I is. The I is said to be the square root of negative 1. Okay, so if this is the case, that would mean that negative I would be what? Negative square root of negative 1. Okay, now I want to bring to your notice that negative I is equal to, I can split this, negative 1 times square root of negative 1. Okay, so recall that I said that b times square root of a is the same thing as saying square root of a times b squared. Alright, so in this case, our negative 1 outside here is the b. Alright, and also notice that in this our particular case, that a here and b are the same. So let's square this, squaring b, let's square this negative 1. The square of negative 1 gives us 1. So that would mean the square root of negative 1 times the square of b here gives us b squared. So the square of negative 1 will give us 1 times 1. Okay, so evaluating this, you have what? The square root of negative 1, which is equals to I. Therefore, negative I equals I.